have very good teachers here, and we have very good, equipment here, and the staffs are very good. So I think it's nice to come here to learn the skull-based surgery.
I'm doing my learning curve in skull-based surgery. I started with P3 endoscopic approaches, but I would like to move also to more large and typical cranial-based approaches.
My colleague in Germany recommended me to come here, and I think it's very good. Yeah.
The exchange with the participant is great. There is time for question, exchanging ideas, technique. We have debates during the theoretical session. Some people may not agree on techniques, but it gives some balance to the message that we send to the participants.
I think, you know, we are teachers, but you're always learning things as you teach someone.
It's always an interesting experience because we see what other experts do actually. So we can confront our technique with others. Just a different variation of the same technique, but it's each time that you come, you pick up a few tips and tricks to improve your technique and to get better with time.
This approach for base of skull surgery is important because I think 50% of lesions in skull base can be reached by this approach. And workshop in cadaveric specimen is important for this aspect of the surgery.
It's what the participant want when they come here. It's for the dissection, it's for the quality of the cadaveric dissection, of the material, of the different device, and I think it's the major point.
First of all, you know, we teach in many courses. The first thing with the IRCAD course is how well equipped it is.
So they have everything from the endoscope to the microscope, and all the instruments are up to very very modern and very everything is available. It's also we have, I think, a great bunch of people helping them. So at least one expert per two teams. So it's a great proximity also for us to give them some tips directly.
Courses like this are essential, but it's not sufficient, I believe. Those courses give you an idea, an overview of skull-based surgery, the taste of it. And if you are a practicing neurosurgeon, it may bring you to the next level. But the base, I think, is to spend a long time in a lab, in a research institute, to learn the anatomy, to perform those techniques, to train on those techniques.
I think the main quality of neurosurgeon would be the fact they will work in a team with the ENT surgeon.